Hi, this is rickysun. I am a piconsultant. Today, I'd like to make a technical video on PiWeb API. Why am I doing that? Because my client has been using piOLED Enterprise and it is slow. He want to pull data to Azure Data Factory and also the SQL Server there. With piOLED Enterprise, it was okay, but we want to explore different alternative, and there could be also, you know, Pi integrator for business analytics. That is also another option, and also Aveva data hub, right? That is also another option that we don't want to go to because we don't want to spend money on additional software, and those two that I mentioned are expensive. OLED Enterprise is not as expensive as the other option. That's why we are going for those route. And PiWeb API become an option because it can pull data to the Azure cloud as well. So it needs a little programming. Our developer in-house will be able to do the programming for us. I just need to educate them how to do that. Previously, we didn't use PiWeb API, so I have to set some configuration in our PiFD database to AF configuration database. Because in order to enable PiWeb API to allow people to do GET requests or, you know, HTTP requests, we need to set quotes. What is it? I was like having a hard time knowing what it is. And the definition of cross is cross origin resources sharing. And what does it mean? It is basically allowing people to send HTTP requests over the internet so that they can get data from different resources. And from our point of view is, we have a PiWeb API, PiWeb API servers, and there is backend AF servers and Pi data archive as well. And our develop application, which I call it a client, will get requests to get the data from the Pi servers and the AF servers. So this is important to set it up, otherwise it won't work. Just not allowing you to authenticate to the PiWeb API server. Without spending too much resources on security, we decided to go for basic authentication from the court. We were using Kerberos authentication for PiVision and PiWeb API, and one more security, which is basic authentication. So people, if they cannot authenticate with Kerberos, which I talked about before, how to set Kerberos delegation up, you have to set this basic authentication over to allow PiWeb API to use basic authentication. And it is in the configuration database within AF, PiFD database. Within the system configuration of that configuration database, you have to set a couple things, not too much, but I guess the first thing is to add that basic authentication as a second authentication method. And then the other one is court support credential, set it to true. It was false. So you have to set that to true. What I'm doing is like super simple telling you what to do, but you know, I don't want to get into the nerdy, greedy stuff about and why this security is there. But setting it up, you also need to put in the quotes method. Originally, in the configuration database, it will have get an option. But now you have to put in post, patch, and delete, and put in there. It depends on what you need, right? Like, but I would say if you are starting to use PiWeb API, I think at the minimum you need get and post. So put that in, right, as a quote method. And once you've done that three things, add that into your configuration database. then you can start using PyWeb API. How do you use PyWeb API then? Like, do I go to the website, or you can go to a web browser and type in the URL of where the PyWeb API located, and then you can see the link of getting data from AF or the data archive. But the suggested method actually to test it is to use Postman, the desktop version as well. The Postman is a desktop application you can install in your laptop or desktop that allows you to put in your authentication method. In my case, it will be basic authentication, and then I can put in username password there, as well as my HTTP request, which is maybe get request of a link, and that link of the URL will be PyWeb API servers link. So you can do get requests, right? Like that we get just get some data, right? I want some data. Get request over, get some data, right? You can get a stream, like a tag data, current time, or you can get historical data, the recorded data, right? You can do that. What I wish to know, but I haven't before, was knowing how to use batch requests. What I said before, like get requests, you do a request and then you wait for the answers, right? But batch requests will allow us to make that batch request, and then within the batch request, there is content there. And you can do get requests, post requests, everything inside that batch request. Then you would be able to do multiple things in one request, if that making sense. And then the performance of your programming that utilize PyWeb API to get data would be faster, because you are not doing multiple requests and then you wait for the response. You are doing one request and then everything execute at once and then come back with the result. It's kind of like a multi-thread kind of thing, I guess. If you do that, then you do one request. In that request of the batch request, you do multiple things at once. And then you don't have to wait that information to come back like multiple times. Let's say you have 10 get requests you wanted to do and then one post request. Then you have 11 requests going through the internet or the network, versus batch request will be one batch request, and then within that one batch request there is 11 things, and you can do one request and get 11 result back. And that's kind of like the power of batch request as well, and I like it and I really want to share. Maybe I will make a video on the live demo or something, but you know, that's the basic concept of how to utilize PyWeb API, right? That's kind of all the things you need to know to set it up, as well as getting started. You need to install PyWeb API first, but then you need to change the configuration database with all the stuff that I talked about, and then Postman, and then do simple get requests with basic authentication, and then batch requests. Okay, thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe as well as hitting the bell icon. I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching. Bye.